Hey everybody, it's Fortyware. Welcome back to Chroma Squad. Last time we started Season 3, and it looks like we have the underpinnings of our lead going Hollywood, and DM decided to go on a critting spree for the ages. So, I was a little concerned at the end of last episode because Izzy wasn't hitting hard at all, and what I did was I got the elite gloves for everybody now since I actually had the money to do it. So, that raised his attack up to a more respectable level, and it also kept his skill regen the same, which I didn't realize. And I also did the same for Ryu, so now everybody has the same gloves. I also got a new helmet. I created a custom hero helmet, so it gives you health, and it also gives you two random properties. Well, if the random properties are dodge and crit, well, naturally, I'm going to give it to my scout, and who now has a dodge rate of 46% and a crit rate of 33%. Do you see where this may be going here? We could be looking at somebody who's becoming quite powerful. Very hard to hit, crits a ton, Owen hits pretty hard to begin with. It also gave him some health, because he is easily the lowest, has the lowest health of anybody right now. So that was worth it. Anyway, has Smash gone too far? We're about to find out. Once again, no Kaiju. Two parts, kind of a throwaway, but eh, let's do it. This really is kind of like a throwaway episode.
My friend told me she would come to record the episode. She's the one with that terrible pigeon costume.
That's not a good pitch.
I don't think we need her, Dr. Suplex. We need better crafted monsters.
I'm sorry about our canceling on her. We may have someone else in bird costume next week.
No need to cancel, Dr. Suplex, but we should listen to Smash and aim for more quality.
Suddenly, a samurai-esque figure appears in at the recording set. Whoa, that's cool.
Are 40 Ounce Studios episodes being recorded here?
I can't do a machine voice, but I would like to.
Yes, but who are you? I'm the true and only Red Samurai. Prepare.
God, if I could do Darth Vader voice, that'd be amazing right now, but I can't. I need a machine or something.
I found that samurai side this
time?
I guess so. Cool outfit, dude.
And awesome music. So hit the boss in the first turn. Well, that'd be our samurai friend, but he's kind of scary. Look at that counter rate. That dodge rate too. So as you see, he's gonna be an SOB. Well, we got him in the first turn. We got to win in 10 turns. So, what are we going to do about this? Well, probably the wisest thing to do is set up a teamwork. We need to eliminate some of the people around the premises. And that's not a bad start. Let's get the coup de grace. Obviously, the big key here is to try quickly to get myself... Here is to try quickly to get myself a morph, because I might need it desperately. Look at all the shooters, and you'll get the idea. Okay, the crit was not something that came extra, but I'll gladly take it. Anyway, two-man game! Bam! And I didn't get any counter there, too. So, good start, and thank you, Smash, for dodging. Thank you, GM, for dodging. No, thank you, Izzy, for not dodging, or Ryu. Oh, thank you, Ryu, for dodging. And this might hurt a little bit. This son of a gun. Oh, man. Shanks, and you also inflicted something called bleeding. Damage over time. That kind of sucks ass, really. But let's not worry about that. Let's worry about some good old-fashioned labatting. And awesome music alert, too.
One bourbon, one scotch, one beer.
So, that first turn actually went a lot better than I expected, truthfully. But of course, the other thing I'm going to try to do here is get people over here, stunning pose, and of course, a little bit of stabby stabby.
Feel the knives of betrayal.
Where have I heard this before? DM just critted. again. This is getting just ridiculous, but I'm loving every second of it. Like, honestly, can you get a little... Can you get more powerful than that if you're critting every single time? It really does severely... severely decimate the enemy. Woo! I love it. I also think I want to get Izzy. You know what? I'll set Izzy over here. I'll set the two-man game that way. Meanwhile... Let's just kadoing this guy. And then... We'll shoot this guy. And that is going to hurt. Hey, don't fair. Don't hide behind that. And it looks like that bleed only lasted one turn, thankfully. So that's good news. Meanwhile. God, I can't get over how awesome this track is. I love this track so much. I also love doing 125 damage. And eliminate one red guy. And, well, remember, can't counter, and it won't miss either. So I think that kick is a very good option. And he's also in finish it mode right now, which is great, obviously.
40 doesn't pay me enough to get hit.
Oh, look, DM dodged again. Hey, stop it. And apparently that thing stacks too, because why not? Well, either way. Unnecessary crit notwithstanding. I can wait one turn, have my back in the corner, just to help myself out a little bit. Because obviously this guy's whole thing is pursuit. He's going to try to pursue you nonstop. So as long as I'm waiting, I'll be in good shape. I'm just going to set up a heal here, just so everybody stays up. And let's watch. Shank. All right. Yeah, everybody's bleeding now. I think Banks could be losing quite a bit of health. Anyway, with that in mind, we are going to destroy this guy now. Three. Unfortunately, it doesn't look like I'm going to be able to get all my weapons in, but that's okay. We do get to finish it, and that's exactly what I need.
Margarita Peel!
And mission accomplished.
Shivakaro, I have failed you. But this ain't over yet. What? I'm sure I heard this name before in a samurai series. Our references are so obscure.
Well, so what the hell are you doing over there, paparazzi guy? I saw that.
Well, whoever hired that guy. It was much better than the terrible pigeon costume. Spelled with a D now.
Then, the terrible pigeon costume girl arrives at the set. And that is terrible.
So you are the terrifying pigeon costume girl. Since you're here, let's record already.
Watch your ass, Thrust! Strong enough to hit you like a truck! Enough, both of you. Let's get to the right set. Come on, everyone.
Terrible or not, I'm just gonna point at the fact we're fighting a freaking pigeon now. I always thought pigeon was spelled without the D. Like, apparently I'm wrong. Or maybe it's an alternate spelling. Actually, one of the weirdest ones I heard was that there were two accepted pronunciations for nuclear. I didn't realize that I always said nuclear. I always thought that's how you're supposed to say it. But apparently nuclear is an accepted pronunciation for that word, which I never understood. Let's see, what voice do I want to do for this?
Trembling fear, Barbatron. They call me, has science gone too far, Duff?
That is a really long name. And you'll see the science hasn't gone far enough yet! Minions!
You gotta be kidding me here. That is, what type of name is that? Has science gone too far enough?
Cool. Huh?
A pigeon sound?
Anyway, above 30% health, defeat the boss with the lead, and we can already finish Has Science Gone Too Far Bird. Already. Well, as you see, 260 HP, really not a contest here. So let's just start with... Well, really, all we're here to do is just completely smack this person. Oh, and this just in, DM created again. I mean, I'm not sure if you've heard this before, but DM seems to be critting people. Also, that's awesome right there. So anyway, the whole thing I'm going to try here is I'm going to try to get a few weapons off. We're not going to go for the finisher, I've decided. I'm just going to go for that, and then I'm going to go for the ka-donk-a-donk. All right. About... No! Doink. Done. One turn. Next.
Ouch, there's only hit that smart smash.
Well, it's living up to his name. Smash.
I'm sorry, Dr. Suplex. I'm not paid to be beat up like this.
Oh, that's terrible to mean like that. I swear I didn't mean to hurt anyone, but it can't look too fake. Actually, Smash, you've been kind of rude since this Gaga appeared. So everyone, I'm just trying to make the best show possible.
Indeed. Yeah, that was so easy, we couldn't even get the freaking audience up! Ugh, that sucks. Yeah, well. Also, still making bank, if you're wondering. What's our email list? Party in 2 days! Our neighbor asked me to send this email to invite you over. Big day, cake, and lots of soda. Yeah. Yes, we'll go there anyway. Why not? We're not Susie, but who cares? Okay. Whoops. Oh well. Come on, we're celebrities. Surprise celebrity showing up out of the goodness of their hearts? Not enough of that. It's also really awesome whenever it does happen. Trust me on that point. Come on, it's always heartwarming whenever you see a celebrity just like randomly show up in a pickup basketball game or something. I remember that's what I think Shaq used to do that a bunch. That was always cool. Seeing people do that. Or just even just like simple cameos. I always got a huge kick out of that. Especially as a sports fan, I used to love the Disney show The Jersey because of that. You get some cameos from players like Jerry Rice, my favorite football player of all time. Jeremy Roenick showed up, I remember him one. Charles Woodson, Michael Johnson, who was the fastest man in the world at the time. I believe that might have been like 96. But that was awesome back in the day, so it's always a good idea. It's always cool when you ever see that. Anyway, got one episode left on that. Good. I think we are done here. Next time, we are not going to be facing Has Science Gone Too Far at all. We are now facing This Is No Food At All! And we have a celebrity here, and we have one part. Kind of reminds me of the pig one, where the pig goes and eats everything. And then you feed it something really hot, and all of a sudden it sneezes it out. Actually, you know what? We can do this right now. Location's at an anime con. It's one part, so why not? Let's go. Accomplished multiple episodes this time. I feel like I've accomplished something.
I'm loving this convention. Maybe we can make some Mikaka's action figure. I love that character, Heart!
Oh, God.
No, no, no. Eden is way cooler than her.
I'm actually hungry. Do any of you want a cupcake? I'm gonna grab a few ones.
Yeah, sure.
This is funny, the place is empty. As if something happened or is about to happen. Hello? Is anyone here?
Dude with shades. Hi, I'm sorry. My name is Stephen McFeely. That's a scary-ass name. How can I... Whoa, whoa, whoa! Wait a moment! Are you Smash and Bar Patrol? I'm a super fan. How can I help you?
Yes, I am.
Well, are you selling some cupcakes?
At the stand says hot dog. Just one hot dog, by the way. I wasn't selling any. This is a hot dog shop.
Hot dogs are way better.
Okay, I really shouldn't say that. They're both awesome, and they both serve two different purposes. So, one's a snack, one's a dessert, honestly. But something odd happened earlier. Everyone vanished from the conference, and this creepy dude jumped out of the shadows. He told me I need to sell this cupcake to someone important. I guess it was you. This is suspicious? Well, this certainly looks very odd. Give me two cupcakes, then. I just have this one. One? Okay, it should be mine, then.
Because you really can't cut a cupcake five... You can't cut a cupcake five ways! Be real here!
I'm usually doing more of the hard work as the lead, so I deserve a bit more.
Not fair.
I can bake some for you later, Ryu.
Well, Tenkai cooking is the best cooking I've learned, so. Suddenly, a really weird sound echoes around the place. And the seemingly delicious cupcake transforms into a terrible monster. Oh my.
No, you were supposed to split me into tiny pieces and eat me like a team. And then I would explode you from the inside. Arr!
What? Who are you?
Everything makes sense now. Am I on the show? This is amazing!
You had such an evil plan!
What a name. Oh my god.
Obviously, that's why they call me the Evil Cupcake.
Sit back, sugar! You ruined your own plan!
No! How could I?
Sweet as sugar, hard as ice, hear me once and I'll beat you twice, minions!
I think I ran out of voices yesterday, so... I'm probably gonna be repeating soon. Also, why are enemies coming out of the restrooms? Both restrooms, I might add. And those guys walk through the wall.
Mr. Evil Cupcake, let's do this!
Wait a second. Are you allowed to call all these minions? So unfair. Then I call myself the Hell Bar Patrol as an apology to try to sell you into their bellies. I just love a random fan.
I just love when random fans join us in these battles.
No, definitely not just a random fan, is he? I'm a great mathematician, and I don't bring math skills that can be very useful. Mostly versus monsters. Great, we have a saber matrician on our side now.
I always wonder what the average spectators think of our episodes. They might get really lost sometimes.
Enough! Fight with me now, Bar Patrol!
Two enemies down in the first turn, defeat every minion. Okay, well that's pretty simple. And remember, McFeely can fight too, and he has an axe for some reason. A mathematician! A mathematical axe! What? Just what? Well, anyway. All the better to do two-man games with, right? That's one down. That's two down already. Alright. We can Labatt's already. That's very good news. But of course, we're gonna hold off. Set the two-man game up. Get some cotton along the way. Honestly, I didn't realize how much cotton I had, so I actually converted it into leather. I had like 25 cotton and like 25 gold duct tapes, so I was rolling in it for a minute there. But more importantly, sweet tongue, what?
Oh yeah, he can drag you in. And dodge! You dragged the wrong person in, buddy. And now for that, you will be met with a Labatt's.
One bourbon, one scotch, one beer.
This is gonna end very well. Start with a stunning pose. In hindsight, I probably could have put Big there, but you know what? I'm gonna send Big over here. Feels better to just do a square house kick on these guys, and hopefully take care of that guy soon. Meanwhile, Dagger. Need we say more? Somebody just created again. Mama, there goes that man again! Seriously, does he ever get tired of critting? I don't think he ever does. All I know is I don't get tired of seeing it. It makes life easier for me, you know? And... down! Maybe not. Oh yes, I got the mathematical axe. Mathematical axe! Not bad, considering. Considering the defense was in play, that wasn't too bad. Up. There's that 40-some-odd percent in play.
You dare touch the doctor?
Okay, come on. That's a free action, really? You gotta be joking. Up. Ha! Somebody critted again. Somebody's getting good at this critting thing. Science may not have gone too far, but the crits are starting to really add up. And I'm loving it. Awesome, McFeely has quite a bit of HP, so I might as well take full advantage of that. Hey, I call hacks. DM's not dodging. If I'm getting all the crits in the world, maybe I should be getting some dodges too. Ooh, nice, got a counter. And he's already in fit. I can already finish him, which is pretty awesome. So, you know, can't complain about that. Woodboard, nice. Set a teamwork over here. And that should send me over here. We do this.
Ha! Get smashed.
Smash got a crit there too. Wonderful. Target practice. Acrylic paint, I need that too, which is nice.
Spotlight's on you, pal.
How hard do you hit? Eh. Might as well do a two-man game then. That way, he'll be dead to rights next turn. Of course, I need to get rid of that one minion first, but I can use McFeely to do that. Or, I hope I can use McFeely to do that. Oh, I can use McFeely to do that, provided he hits. The power of math, the king of all sciences. And also apparently the king of disappointment. Oh well, let's get rid of that minion then. So we don't need a finisher here. So you know what? That gives me a good excuse to try to crit my way to the top again. Because somebody's pretty good at that sort of thing. But since we don't have that, I'll just simply do a three-man game. And, better not do that. Three-man game, goodbye. There you go. All enemies down, all minions down.
It's time to your flavor explosion! No!
Well, that was a huge explosion. Explosive diarrhea, I might dare to say.
Steven, thank you for your help. It was a great time fighting by your side.
Now the evil cupcake is gone, maybe people will go back and I'll be able to keep some of my hot dogs.
Can you make one for each of us then? We're still hungry!
Damn right. Nothing like a post-game meal. Those are the best, especially after games. Tough games. I used to enjoy that as a kid. After a baseball game, post-game meal every time. So fun. And we're still making bank. Now we're in five digits. Salaries and stuff. From Smash, to your person who's playing this game. Time for a little salary upgrade. That's Smash. I don't know what this'll do, but, we're gonna be we're gonna be good to everybody. We're gonna be good to everybody. And also Kyle. Dr. Suplex's little brother. Oh yes, please come. The little Suplex. This is Dr. Suplex writing this message from Kyle's account. We're sorry for the things Kyle has done or broken our studio. I'll pay my own son. Ah, jeez. So he's not the only one that inflicts pain and destruction. Alright, anyway. That worked out very well. You see, I'm swimming in dough right now. So, marketing fan power. I'm not sure what actually the difference between that and fan conversion is, or audience. It might be actually like getting more fans, I'm not sure. I heard a sound there. Anyway, I'll figure out agency on my own time. Anyway, see you guys later, as we will take care of interferences. 40 Warriors signing off.